Hello, this is Bern, and in today's video, I'm going to reveal the elusive and powerful thing that men need and crave more than sex, and how you can become gifted at offering it to the right guy. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and enter the relationship you crave without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or silly techniques. If this is your first time here and this type of subject really interests you, make sure to click the subscribe button right now so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. Now, there's a lot of talk out and about the needs of men, including an exaggeration about the need men have for sex. Well, it's true that men have a great need for sex. There's something deeper than sex that men are craving for. And most of us don't have the language to express it, but that does not mean that we don't have that need. So what am I talking about? I'm talking about what I call a loving sanctuary. A loving sanctuary is a few things. It's a holy or sacred space. I'm not talking religion here. I'm talking a holy or sacred space where you can be you. A place that provides refuge or safety from the troubles of life, a reprieve from the suffering and confusion and shit that sometimes life throws at you. Think about it. Most of us, I'm talking about men, go out and about in our own unique way by adding some value, by making changes, by having a sense of direction, but we may not have the language to express that part of us that wants to be fully seen and expressed and witnessed and loved. So if you, as a woman, with your infinite wisdom and your gigantic heart, can create a space for your man to be himself at a deeper level, he will create a connection with you unlike any other connection he's created in his life. And the thing about it is, most women have an inkling of what this could be about, but don't necessarily know how to do it. So what I want to do today, beyond expressing that men need a loving sanctuary and that you can offer a loving sanctuary to a specific type of man, is how to do it. Because otherwise it would be like me saying, hey, you know how to attract the ideal guy? Be radiant and full of feminine energy. Well, how the hell do you do that? It's not as simple as it sounds. So I'm going to express to you right now, beyond explaining what this is, how to step into creating a loving sanctuary for the right guy. Before I do that, before I go into my several steps of how you can step into this, let me just share that if you want to take this video way further than I can express in this short time, there's a link on the first link in the description of this video that will allow you to access my free training that will show you how to take this beyond intellectual understanding and embody the changes. All you have to do is click the first link, enter your name and email, you'll see a page that looks like this, and you can start watching that training right away, and it's totally free. Here's the step zero of what I'm sharing with you. You need to do this not with just any guy, but a guy that you have a strong connection with, number one. Number two, you need to choose a man who is hungry for more intimacy, hungry for more wisdom, hungry for more knowledge, hungry for more evolution, hungry for more change, hungry for more witnessing, hungry for more love. Why? Because if you waste this on men who don't have that craving inside of them, then you can be doing all the right steps and still not get what you want. Now, that's not to say that you're doing the right steps right now, but at least with understanding this, you can practice and see how far you can go with your chosen guy. So step number one is you need to seize an opportunity when you see one. Remember Dead Poet Societies, when he says seize the day? Well, seize the moment. Seize the moment means there's gonna be a time where your guy shares one inch, one opening in terms of there's a deep craving in his soul to express more, to share his deep feelings, to be vulnerable with you. And if you're patient throughout this process, then he can go deeper and deeper. If you rush the process, he's gonna close out and be done with the whole thing. So it's important for you to understand that when you see that your guy is about to be slightly more vulnerable, slightly more expressive, slightly more open in his sharing, that you be present and that you understand that it's gonna take maybe a while before you can actually do this few steps in a way that feels like the most open, loving embrace and the deepest conversation you've had with him. Number two is presence and breath are your allies. That means when he does that, drop what you're doing. Drop the phone, drop the dialogue in your mind, drop the other stuff that is not as relevant, as important as that experience, and take ownership and control of your breath. Here's why, because he's gonna start sharing things that might make you feel uneasy, that might create feelings that are intense in you because of the nature it may, and sometimes it's empathy, sometimes it's just feeling for him. But if you're in command of your breath, you'll be able to hold space in a way where it's not about you in that moment, it's about him. The other thing I have to share is that physical closeness can be your greatest ally, but if you force it, it's not gonna work towards the goal that we're talking about right now. So here's what I mean. Would it be awesome to have your guy be fully embraced by you? Maybe he's crying and he's sharing his deepest thoughts with you. That would be amazing. Maybe you look into his eyes, holding his hands, but it may not be possible. He might need to go inside, look somewhere else, and not even physically be touching you. So allow the openness where if he wants to do that, it's possible, but don't force it on him. Number three, remember the rule of 90-10. That means you're 90% of the time in that interaction, you're going to listen to him, and 10% you're going to speak, clarify, ask questions, nod, reassure him that you're present. Because if you get excited and start creating a monologue or start asking too many questions back to back, he is going to feel overwhelmed because he's not necessarily the expert at expressing his emotions. And if he feels overwhelmed, he's gonna shut down, and then the moment is gone and you can no longer continue. So make sure to remember the 90-10 rule. Number four, you need to really work in this. You need to not confuse he's dropping his shield with weakness. You need to be okay with his flow. Here's what I mean by that. It's really cool when women share with me that they want for their guys to be more open, but the moment he becomes more open, because especially if it's something he's not used to doing, there's a weirdness that takes place, especially if you see him in a space that you don't usually see him at, more vulnerable, more expressive, more deep feeling, in more pain than he usually lets out, for you to feel shaken up. And if you understand that it's a process, it's a circle, it starts here, it may go down, it's gonna come back up. If you understand that, you'll be cool. If you start falling into just going with all those emotions, it's going to be challenging for you. And you might even think that he's not being strong, the strong guy who usually embraces you when you cry, who usually has a solution, all of a sudden doesn't have any solutions, all of a sudden is not strong enough to hold you in that moment, but he's strong enough to open his heart. Recognize that him opening his heart is one of the greatest acts of courage he could be stepping into, especially in light of people telling him his entire life that he shouldn't do it, that it's not okay, that he's gay for doing so, that he's a weak man, that he's a sissy, all the things that men, even to this day, continue hearing when they open their hearts and express emotions. This is a sensitive moment for him. So you need to understand that it's a strength versus a weakness and be okay regardless of what spirals down in that conversation. Number five, and it's not just with him, this is in life in general, so you can be better when this moment comes, is practice opening your heart and holding that space without judgment. If you are judging him, he will feel it. His sensitivity will be more heightened. So he'll be able to see in your physical posture, in your body language, in the way you look at him, in the way you breathe, in the way you roll your eyes, he's gonna see if there's judgment in you. You need to do your best in those brief moments to open your heart and remove judgment and allow him to be something that he rarely gets the experience to have. Number six, that is, you need to accept and encourage his vulnerable imperfection, meaning he's gonna make mistakes when he says things. He's going to be introspective. He's going to doubt himself. And as long as you continue encouraging him, saying, this is great, it's okay, I can take this, I understand what you're sharing, please share more. If you verbally and non-verbally encourage his vulnerable imperfection, he will be far more likely. They don't have to be so self-conscious. I can focus on expressing versus, is she understanding this? Is she cool with this? Is she seeing me as weak? It's a combination of the previous step, but it's encouraging verbally and non-verbally to continue expressing himself. Number seven, when he needs to be reminded, there might come a point in this expression of himself that he might lose track of who he is. He might go deep into shame. He might go deep into some level of feeling that is so pervasive that he loses sight of his greatness. You need to remember who this great man is and remind him of him in those moments so he can come back to his true identity versus the identity he's creating in that moment of a guy who is maybe a loser, maybe somebody who's a bad human being because he did something that he regrets. You need to make sure to remind him of his identity. Number 8, you need to remember that the greatest benchmark of friendship is not evolution, is not the betterment of each other, is witness. Think about it. Think about the privilege that it is to have the ability to witness someone naked, emotionally, physically, spiritually. Think about the huge responsibility that provides, but also the closeness, also the loyalty, also the love that gets created when both of you are able to witness each other. And I know that some of you might be saying, well, why do I have to do this for him? The truth is, if he's a great man, he already does some of this for you. If he's the kind of man who's strong when you're feeling open, if he's the kind of man that embraces you when you feel shaky, who provides strength when you feel maybe scared, then this is the counterpart of that. And men, however strong they appear in the world, need this as much as you do. Last thing I'll share is practice the golden rule, which is he's going to share things in those moments. The more you practice and the better you do this, that will be things that you need to keep as a sacred contract between both of you. If you bring this up in front of other people, if you passively aggressively remind him of this, if when you want to hurt him because he did something bad, you remind him of this, he will shut down in a way that will be hard to come back from. So make sure that whatever is expressed in those moments stays within the relationship and that you treat it with utmost respect. Whenever you bring it up, you bring it so in a delicate way, gauging how far you can go. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you. If it is, and you want to go deeper than I can share in this video, make sure to hit the first link on the description of this video right now so you can watch my free training that will show you how you can take this to the next level. If you enjoy this video, please click like or thumbs up. Subscribe to my video so you can be notified of new episodes. You can even share on a comment what's the biggest benefit you got from this video. And last but not least, if you're someone who's been attempting to attract the guy you want, attempting to create the best relationship of your life, and you're not being able to do that despite watching videos, doing the law of attraction, going to therapy, or even being a therapist, if you might highly benefit from working with me, if you want to find out if we're a fit to work together, second link on the description of this video will allow you to connect with me. And if we're a fit, then I'll share with you how I can help you get what you want in a fraction of the time. Thank you so much for opening your heart and for allowing me into your computer, into your phone today. Hope you get exactly what you want. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and conscious life.